us again. Just a reminder, we're doing everything we can to keep you safe and healthy while you're here. We ask that you stay in your seats for the entire worship service, and that you keep your mask on for the entire time you're in the building. Should you need to use the restrooms, go straight out the doors from the seat at the end of the hall. There's a restroom sign pointing to the right. Make a right right there, and you'll see the restrooms on the right-hand side.
Lead us by your love to love our neighbors as ourselves. Amen.
All have sinned. which he bowed down at his feet. Now the woman was a Gentile, of Syrophoenician origin. She begged him to cast out the demon from her daughter. He said to her, "Let the children be fed first, for it is not right, it is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." But she answered him, "Sir, even the dogs under the table eat the children's crumbs." Then he said to her, "For saying that, you may go. The demon has left your daughter." She went home and found her child laying in the bed, and the demon was gone. Then he returned from the region of Tyre and went by way of Sidon toward the Sea of Galilee, near the region of Decapolis. They brought to him a deaf man who had an impediment in his speech, and they begged him to lay his hand on him. He took him aside in private, away from the crowd. He put his finger into his ears and spat and touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and sighed and said, "Ephphatha," that is, "be opened." And immediately his ears were opened and his tongue was released, and he spoke plainly. Then Jesus ordered them to tell no one, but the more he ordered them, the more zealously they proclaimed it. They were astounded beyond measure, saying, "He has done everything well. He even makes the deaf to hear and the mute to speak." The gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, in Jesus Christ, you come among us to reveal your redeeming love and grace. Open our hearts and our minds to hear your word, and through the power of your Holy Spirit, grant us a deeper understanding and appreciation for that love and grace, and empower us to share it with those you put in our lives. We ask this in Christ's holy name.
Amen.
Our gospel lesson this morning contains two healing stories, and how they take place can't be more different. One of the commentaries that I read laments that the church's decision to pair these two healing stories together in a single lesson. But it's not as though the contrasting stories were pulled from two different places in Mark. Mark chose to contrast these two healing stories. So that means there's certainly something that there's a purpose that we need to consider. We're told Jesus leaves Galilee, travels to the region of Tyre, hoping to be unnoticed, hoping to get some rest that he's not able to in his hometown. But apparently, even in the foreign region, Jesus could not go unrecognized. Even these people had heard of his healing powers. And it didn't take long for a Gentile woman, a Syrophoenician origin, to come to Jesus, to fall at his feet, and to beg him to heal her daughter. But the woman was an outsider. In fact, one of the commentaries put it, she was a triple outsider. She was of Syrian nationality, Greek in religion, and a female in gender. On top of that, she was a very outspoken woman, which meant she also offended the gender bias that women should keep silent in the presence of men, especially a rabbi. Some would consider her about as far from the God of Israel as you could possibly get. And how does Jesus respond to her request? Initially, Jesus refuses to heal this woman's daughter, possibly because she was not an Israelite, or because she was of a different religion, because she was such an outspoken woman. And notice, not only did he refuse to heal the daughter, he insults this woman and her people by saying, "Let the children be fed first, for it is not fair to take the food from the children and feed it to the dogs." How many of you think this is very out of character for Jesus? We always think of Jesus as this kind, loving, humble person, especially caring for the least and the last, the lost, and the forgotten. by itself, if it has no works, is dead. In the same lesson, James also lists up the command that sums everything up, that sums up our faith journey. You do well if you really fulfill the royal law according to Scripture. What is that royal law according to Scripture? Somebody other than Pastor Harry. Love your neighbor as yourself. Love your neighbor as yourself. Throughout Scripture, we hear Jesus giving that command to love, to love, to love. Most notably, when he loves. When he was in that upper room, sharing that final meal with his disciples, where then he willingly and lovingly took that journey to the cross. And the empty grave 3 days later, to love his neighbor. This command to love is how we act out our faith. It is how we respond to our belief that God loves us enough to die for us. Now keep in mind, we don't act out our faith with hopes to achieve God's grace and love. That would be called works righteousness, right, Pastor Aaron? We do so in our
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Especially we pray for our Thank you.
the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no